and our resulting track. There it is, I can select it. There's the waypoints. I can export it, send track, KMZ to folder. KMZ file is a Google Earth file. So we can then import it into Google Earth and see where we went, photos and all. Let me just zip across to the map. And that's where we went. If I tap these waypoints, you can see the photos down here. And if I tap on the track, you can see the height gradient, the altitude gradient. And I can select a point on this, and the point moves here, the little green dot. Showing the height at each point as I went. Two-fingered pinch zoom. Two-fingered slide. Now, suppose your wife also has a copy of Donde and you want to send her your location. You do this by clicking send and my location SMS, and it will send your location as an SMS to your wife, which will be recognized by Donde and imported. SMS because it just needs a GSM network, it doesn't need a data network. And it's available everywhere, and even if she doesn't have Donde, a normal phone will display the SMS with the location. So I'm going to enter her telephone number now. And I click send. Message is received. And my waypoint is here. Third thing I'm going to show you is warbling guidance. Let's select a different waypoint. Warbling guidance is this button here. When you have a waypoint selected and there's an arrow to go to, then you're offered this button. And you can turn it on or you can turn it off. And when you turn it on, you get the ability to set the volume. And with it on, I can turn the screen off. And now, when I tilt the phone down, it wobbles to give me the direction. And I can lift it up and put it in my pocket upright, and it turns off. So whenever I want to take it out and check the direction, I take it out of my pocket, I tilt it down, and I point around, and I listen for the warbling. And I know which direction I'm heading. There's some other tricks you can do too. Turn it into silent mode. Now it buzzes. So instead of listening to a warble which might annoy you, then you can just feel the buzz, like I can feel it there. Suppose you have two copies of Donde, your wife has one, you have one. You want to send the waypoints from one to the other. You tap send by Bluetooth, select the target phone, accept it on this one. And then we'll add the waypoints. And there you are. It sends the waypoints, it sends the little photos, it sends everything. So now you're synced. So I'm in Google. I've entered a search query, and I'm going to search on that. Now the first entry is the Peak District GPX, which is a list of the caves. Select it. It's recognized as a GPX file. It's passed. And there are 438 caves in this GPX file. So let's add them. And there we have a list of caves. Internet is turned on, we have a Wi-Fi connection, slide across to maps, and a map of London. Now let's zoom in to say, slide across, there's Regent's Park. We'll zoom into Regent's Park, and again, turn off Wi-Fi. Zoom out, zoom out. You see how it's pulling it from the cache, it's not. I can zoom in again. It has a cache copy, the cache lasts 24 hours.